friends here.
Matches the description of the gun stolen from Mr. Sterling's safe. Must be the murder weapon.
She's in surgery at the moment.
Told you Clive was a scary guy.
And Jamie's muscle in the burglary scheme right on bird camps.
Maybe I should become a police consultant. So are they letting Adriana go now?
Well, it seems that you were right about something else. Adriana was part of the scheme. She was the one who told Jamie and Clive about the houses that were ripe for the robbing.
Yeah, because they were forcing her to. Like I said. So who's our new suspect? But there is. There is a new suspect, right?
Mace found the murder weapon at the warehouse with the stolen items. It had Adriana's prints on it.
No. No, it can't be.
Why not? And please don't say because.
Because if it is, I'm to blame. It's my fault. She's broken.
Anyway, enough with the bad news. On to what really matters. The detective and I just had...
A spat, I know. I saw. I know, and now you want me to weigh in on your relationship. That's all this has been from the start, isn't it? You never really cared about helping me. You just needed a ride-along therapist. For once, I need you to care about someone other than yourself. To care I failed. You're just as selfish and self-absorbed as you... What is she doing here?
Like I was saying, the detective and I just had a chat, and then we decided to talk to Adriana again.
But all the evidence points to her. You think she's guilty.
But you don't. My self-centeredness aside, I am trying to help. We all are. And we're not giving up. So, shall we see what your daughter has to say?
Nothing. I have nothing to say. I wrote down everything I know. Well, we looked at your statement and did some legwork. There are some pieces missing that we would like you to fill in. Just close the investigation already.
I did it. That's all I'm going to say.
I'm not sure about that. Tell me, Adriana. What is it you desire?
I want to protect my mother.
My mother's sick. She has been for a while.
The treatment is expensive. So is that why you're having money troubles? Owen told us that.
Yeah.
I mortgaged my condo, deleted my savings. I had nothing left.
Then you met Miss Thomas Cranfair.
Jamie approached you, didn't she? She said we'd make fast cash. She promised no one would get hurt. She convinced you to give up your clients, lab coats, what the valuables were, and when they wouldn't be home.
And tried to the dirty work.
I tried to back out. I did. But they threatened you. They said they'd kill my mom.
I felt trapped. I was looking for a way out.
When I suddenly heard about a last-minute change in Mr. Sterling's travel plans. He was coming home early.
And the night that Clive was supposed to rob his place. I panicked.
You tried to warn Clive? Is that why you texted him? Texted him? No, I called him, and he wasn't picking up, so I rushed over to the house, and... It was too late. Clive must have been surprised by Mr. Sterling and...
Except Clive wasn't stripping down Mr. Sterling's house. He was at some strip club on the strip.
Records show he was in Vegas that night. According to him, you called the sting off early. He said you texted him Friday night.
Friday? No, I didn't even hear about Mr. Sterling's change of plans until Saturday, right before I rushed over to the house. I was at the movies on Friday night. I didn't... Please, you have to believe me. All I want is to protect my mom. All of this I did for her.
Got it. Thanks. Hey, so Adriana's mom safe? Did you find Linda?
No, I guess she's left. Probably got too emotional for her.
Yeah. Oh, control freak Lopez for the win. So see, I myself didn't personally process the murder weapon the first time around, so I said, you know what? I should take another look. And winner, winner, chicken dinner. The gun was wiped down, you guys. And there was just one Adriana fingerprint on it.
That's fishy.
And for the double whammy, I also found methyl acrylate on the gun.
A drug I've never heard of or done. Now that's fishy.
Oh, no, it's not a drug. It's a substance found on the sticky side of scotch tape.
Someone used the tape to transfer the print to the gun.
So, Adriana was framed by Clive?
I don't think so. I checked the phone records. He's not lying. Clive did receive a text from Adriana calling off the job.
But it doesn't mean that Adriana actually sent it.
Right. Who else had access to her phone when she was in the movies?
If only the doctor was still here. She'd probably know what with all her stalking and whatnot.
I think I know who did this.
And that's bad.
Only if Linda figured it out too.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Someone who actually cares about Adriana. Not someone who pretends to care while framing her.
Wait, what?
I saw you step out of the theater. I thought, oh, so polite. He doesn't want to text during the movie. Well, polite my ass. You were texting Clive on Adriana's cell, telling him the sting was off, so you could take the spoils for yourself. You killed Mr.
I've been a terrible mother. I've done nothing for Adriana her entire life. This is the one thing I can do, so I'm saving her from you. One way or another.
Linda, put down the gun.
I can't let him get away with this. He framed Adriana.
This woman is not careful. That woman is a doctor and an excellent one at that. Why would I frame my own girlfriend? I was the one that told you that she was innocent, Detective.
You're also the one who pointed the finger at Jamie, which led us to the warehouse and the murder weapon that you planted, which was smart. But now we have forensic evidence that Adriana's print was transferred to the gun. You're under arrest.
You did it, Doctor. You saved your daughter.
To an open house a while back. I'm a realtor. Oh, right. Maybe. If you're wondering what I'm doing here at the police station, I just, these are my friends. And they were helping me with something important.
That's nice. They helped me too.
Could have been really bad.
I should be going.
Hey. I'm glad you're okay.
Thanks.
All right, Lucifer, you have my undivided attention. What is it that you want to talk to me about?
The only thing I want to talk about is you. So, you told her you aren't mum yet?
No. I'm being respectful.
Well, in the words of a wise woman I know, that sounds an awful lot like avoidance to me.
Boundaries.
Says the stalker. Why didn't you tell her?
I do think it should be her choice, but if I'm being honest, I guess I'm afraid of rejection. I just, not that I have a relationship with her now, I don't know. It doesn't make any sense.
Makes perfect sense. You want to know her, to be with her, it's everything you've ever wanted, but you can't completely open yourself up. Because deep down you actually believe that you don't deserve her love. Because she's so perfect and you're just... well... unworthy.
Awfully insightful of you, Lucifer. Maybe you should become...
looking less like death.
Ha. Thank you.
You know, back there when you got shot, I hated that.
Yeah, it wasn't great for me either.
I never felt like that before. It was weird. New. And I was
afraid?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I felt fear before, but that was a whole other level.
Maze, are you saying what I think you're saying?
leave you to leave. This should take care of that. It has my mother's mortality in it. So I think it will protect you.
This will make me immortal?
Mm-hmm. Hopefully. I almost lost you again. And I've never hurt like that before. I guess I have been as well. But this is what a soul feels like. I don't want to feel it again.
Sweetie, I don't want to live forever.
Why the hell not?
Because I saw what it did to my son, Cain. You saw it too. Mortality is a gift. It makes you appreciate life. Just like fear made you appreciate me. I can't accept this.
No, you have to. You have to. Okay, or I can't do this.
What?
I'm trying to protect you.
No, you're trying to protect yourself.
I almost lost you, Eve. I can't lose you again. Don't you understand?
I love you. Jesus, I love you too very much. That's why this is so scary. But we have to embrace that.
Weren't helping you, were they? You were helping them with my case. I just wanted to say thank you. It's no big deal. Would you like to come in? Sure. Also, there was an anonymous donation made to the clinic where my mom is being treated. A very generous one.
Oh, that's wonderful news. There's something I've been wanting to tell you.
You're my mom. You look at everybody who resembles you, even a little bit. Everybody who's in the right age range. And you wonder.
So the day that I went to the open house,
I had my suspicion. You and the other lady acted so weird.
I wanted to tell you. But I
didn't know if you'd want. Let you come to me. Well, here I am.
Here you are.
You have a baby.
feel unworthy. No, that's not it. I definitely feel worthy. Who else would be? It's just, I spent so much time looking down on your head. And now, Lucy, I love living amongst them. I finally learned. Things will only get better. I'll become omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent, all the omnis.
But how is that good for our relationship?
I'll be there for you whenever and wherever you need me. I'll know exactly what you're thinking.
That's not at all dangerous.
Well, I know exactly when you want me to do that thing that you like, for example. But Detective, this is a good thing. Trust me.
I do. Just...
You need more time to process. Of course you do. Well, in the meantime, how about business as usual? Nice little murder to take your mind off this.
Could you imagine being ripped apart by a shark?
We'll have to.
What do you think the worst part would be? Those big old teeth tearing into your skin, the water filling your lungs as you scream, or the heart attack from the sheer terror of it all.
You never cease to amaze me, Ella. I mean, even the darkest, most morbid stuff gets you excited, and that's because you know that all this works and helps life.
Yeah.
Sharks, one of Earth's most misunderstood creatures. Definitely correcting that, I'm glad.
So, what do we have here?
Bruno Lorenzoni, 33, the chief operator of the aquarium. Pieces were found scattered in the tank.
Obviously, death by shark, right? Wrong. See, this wound right here is way deeper than any sort of tooth. Clean or cut tooth made by some sort of blade. She was dead before she hit the water.
So the killer got the water. body, hoping the sharks would hide the murder?
They should have known we'd smell something fishy.
Aw, dad joke, nice.
Thanks, I'm practicing.
We've located all of her pieces, except for her left arm.
And the fingernails on the hand we do have show some sign of struggle. So I sent the samples back to the lab. Her pieces were in the water for a long time, so it's gonna be tough, but maybe our victim nabbed some killer's DNA? Who found the body?
Elizabeth Newman, the aquarium's owner.
I came in this morning, but Theodore wasn't returning my calls. I never imagined I'd find her like that. This is a nightmare. I don't know how to do any of this without her.
Do you know of anyone who would want Luna dead?
No, I have no idea. She was a pillar of our marine conservation community.
Yeah, she couldn't need saving if my father hadn't been slain. Just saying.
Who had access to the aquarium grounds after hours?
I don't know. Bruno ran everything. I love her animals as much as she does, but she's a more of a money person.
Christ, what a god. I know the answers to all the questions. No asking used to be here.
Okay, well, you are not god yet, so that is not helpful right now.
I'm just trying to get you as excited about my new promotions. Excuse me.
You weren't answering your phone. Have you heard the news? Father's back.
Really? But why do you look so worried? He's still retiring, isn't he?
Oh yeah, that's definitely still happening.
Excellent. Well, I should go talk to him, get his blessing before our Middleton siblings wake up.
Yeah. About that?
Anyway, if you'll excuse us, sister, we would like to have a chat with dear old dad.
Good to see you, brother.
Sister! Nothing.
Who invited the devil to our gathering of angels?
Still taking your angel of righteousness role too seriously, see?
Nobody?
No, not Hanover deal. It's going to be me.
my full support.
How can that be? All the angels are working.
Who is more qualified than me? Good point. I've been in hell for millennia. Have any of you run your own kingdom? Think so much as a tango truck?
Didn't think so.
Brother, you know I've always followed your lead. Okay, but I cannot support fallen ones.
Father, this is your choice. Not theirs. Tell us who you choose to be your successor.
Children, please. One thing at a time. My retirement plan, then my successor. But first, who wants another hot dog?
Detective, I'm afraid that there has been a speed bump on my road to becoming God.
Oh, no, really?
Yes, before Dad names me God 2.0, he needs a retirement plan. So I thought what better way to prove that I've got material than to make his plans for him.
Huh. Okay. Got it. Well, in earthly matters, we finished interviewing everybody at the aquarium, and aside from a few endangered fish gone missing, we learned that Lucifer...
What, on one of these retirement homes?
No, on the case. A few employees said Bruna was arguing with her husband. They overheard him making threats to her on some screaming match over the phone.
Well, you should bring him in.
You think?
Yes, I threatened my wife. Threatened to leave her. Stupid aquarium. Her entire life, she paid zero attention to anything else.
Including you?
Me, her children, her dogs, housework. She couldn't even keep up with her Fitbit challenges. The night she died, you know where I was? Home. Taking care of her two sick kids by myself.
So you're giving us your alibi?
I watch cop shows, I know how this works. I find plenty of footage of me covered in kid vomit on our nanny cam.
Bruna's employees heard you screaming over the phone. Was that also about her never being around?
That was mostly about the affair. She was making late night calls to some restaurant owner named Jeremy. I followed her to his house, but all they did was argue. Turns out it wasn't an affair. It was just about her fish. Even that was not work. Part of me hoped she was cheating. Just to prove that her aquarium was in her entire universe.
Her universe? Would you say she was sort of the god of the aquarium?
Sure. A god who didn't have time for the one who loved her the most. Me.
God,
you say?
Mm-hmm.
Which of these retirement homes do you think that your godlike wife would enjoy the most? Golden Oldie has the best salad bar, but you can't beat Big Sleep's water aerobics.
Retirement? What are you... Bruna's dead.
Right. Right, well, if you were God, which one do you think you would like to spend your eternity in?
Without my wife by my side.
Well, that doesn't help me at all. My dad's wife is in another dimension.
I'm so sorry.
But maybe Dad could do with a new partner. Well, that's it. Forget retirement homes. You'd give me a much better idea.
Excuse me. What about the case? You haven't even been listening.
Yes, I was. Aquarium, Fitbit, kid vomit, restaurant owner named Jeremy. Wait. It's not Jeremy or Jeremy's fine food, is it? Detective, Jeremy is known in certain circles for serving rare, illegal animals.
The aquarium's missing fish. If Bruna found out that someone was selling the fish to Jeremy and confronted him about it, that's definitely motive for murder.
Having a soul is the worst.
But isn't that what you wanted?
Yeah, until I got one. Got Eve and... Turns out, having a soulmate that can die, it's torture.
There's also something very special about the limited time that we have with someone. Maybe you could focus on what you do have, instead of what you don't.
Not when I know you will end up in heaven. Or I can never go.
You don't know that she's gonna end up in heaven.
She's the brightest, nicest, most caring, honest person ever. Of course she's going to heaven. Well, now that you have a new soul, maybe you'll go too. With all the terrible things I've done, Linda, come on. Definitely go now. But wasn't there a time that all you wanted was to go back there? Yeah. As a hell torturer. But with a soul, if I die, I'll turn up as one of the tortured.
Drinking wine. Besides, if we confront him head on, he'll surely deny, but if we get him to sell us one of his deliciously illegal meats, then voila, leverage.
It's like a sting date combo. You know, that's a nice work-life balance, Lucifer. Maybe I don't need to be so worried about becoming God after all.
I told you. Is retired?
I am not retired.
Right?
Who told you that? My agent?
Oh, sorry, my mistake. Well, you have other things in common. You both lost spouses. So, there's that.
Your wife died?
No, she's just in her own universe.
Isn't that just how relationships fall apart? My John and I, we were the opposite. We were totally connected. Totally supportive of each other. What, you don't agree?
Well, he was completely supportive of you. He gave up his dream of becoming a detective to support your career.
And you're saying that's my fault?
Children, they blame us for everything.
Right? As if we created the world. So, tell me, Godfrey. How long have you been this handsome?
Becomes God and just ask him for help.
change the rules of hell for you.
You got this, right?
What?
Yeah, okay.
No. No, 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 no. Maze, what are you doing? Maze!
My little rebel made such a mess, Edgar.
Chloe's most difficult fans were her goth years. Hot Topic almost bankrupted us.
Okay, enough with the childhood embarrassing stories. Thank you. Godfrey, why don't you tell us about your old job? What kind of work-life balance did you have?
I actually didn't have much of a life. It was pretty much all work.
I'm sure he's exaggerating.
It caused a lot of problems between me and my wife. She always felt like I didn't have enough time for her. Maybe she was right.
Ready to our entrees?
I'm not hungry.
I'm vegan. What? Since when?
Okay, I'll order for the table. Excellent. Would you like to hear our specials for the evening?
Well, actually, just a little specials. I'm going to wait for some Asian animal.
Sir, we don't serve endangered animals here.
That's not what I heard. I'd like to speak with the owner, please.
Sorry, sir. You have the wrong idea.
Well, I think we just blew our shot.
Nearly a slight snack. Anyway, let's concentrate on what's important here. Your mum and my dad, match made in heaven.
Excuse me. Jeremy Morgan, I'm the owner. And I want to apologize for our waiter's behavior. He had no idea we had such an important guest.
That's quite all right.
Miss Decker, I'm a huge fan. Athea, Queen of the Quarks? That should have won you an Oscar.
Oh, my. Well, thank you. And I totally agree.
It is an honor to have you in my restaurant. Now, we don't normally serve first-timers from our secret menu, and sadly, we don't have any arowana, but I do have a delicacy fit for a queen. Ailurapida, Melana Luca, Tartar.
Ooh, sounds so European.
Said you're vegan, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sure you want to eat panda?
Panda?
Jeremy Morgan, you're under arrest.
And I'm sure Peter will agree. Most likely going to hell.
Yesterday on my morning run, I saw this guy about to cross the street. Head in his phone, not paying attention. Moments away from walking into traffic. And my mind started picturing things. Like really vivid things. Which car would hit him first? Which of his bones would shatter? The position his body would land on the ground? Exactly how long it would take him to bleed out? Detail after detail. I eventually snapped out of it, but it was too late.
He got hit?
No. No, he looked up in time, but that's not the point. The point is that helping him wasn't my first thought. Or my second. Or my third. How messed up is that?
You've been coming to see me ever since you caught Pete. And over all of that time, you've never taken a single day off. Maybe it's catching up to you.
No. The job is what centers me. Channels these thoughts into some kind of purpose. The truth is, I've been this way my entire life. I've hidden it from everyone. Dan, Chloe, everyone thinks I'm a good person. I told Amenadale that I would try to accept myself, but how? How can I accept myself when this darkness is such a part of who I am?
least he can do is text me how it went.
As I was saying, we found your freezer full of illegal meats. Bruna found out, didn't she? She was gonna expose you, so you killed her.
I had nothing to do with Bruna's death. I swear.
Yes, I serve exotic meats. Do you have any idea how hard it is to run a restaurant in L.A.? You have to innovate just to stay in business.
Well, the savage isn't lying about that.
Oh, so you are with us?
Sorry.
So, Bruna wasn't aware of what you were up to?
No, she was, but she wasn't trying to stop me. She was trying to sell me some of her fish.
Marine conservationist Bruna, whose whole life was out of court?
I don't know about any of that. All I know is she approached me a few months ago and offered to sell me some bluefin tuna. It's hard to come by these days, so I bought some. I have the wire transfers to prove it.
If you guys were in business together, what were you arguing about?
A week ago, she offered me her rarest fish. She said she needed to sell $47,000 worth, but I just maxed out my budget on Bald Eagle. So I turned her down. She freaked out and left, and that's the last time I had any contact with her.
Where were you at the murder?
At my restaurant. My employees can verify.
Oh, for dad's sake. I know he has big fingers, but these texts are simply indecipherable. I'm just gonna call him. Excuse me, Detective Wolfgang Yuck.
We're gonna need those wire transfers.
Oh, come on, just answer the bloody phone. Oh, there you are. So, how'd it go? Ready to ride off into the sunset?
Right. That would be lovely. Just a few millennia too young for me.
Right. Okay. No double decker. There's no more fish in the sea. I'll find you a match if it's the last non-god thing I do.
Listen, you're not listening. There is and will always be only one woman I will ever love.
Plan a different element of your retirement then.
Son, I don't need your help.
But I need to make sure that everything's ready. Unless, of course, you just want to name your successor now, perhaps someone who's passionate about making plans, if you know what I mean.
You mean someone who's trying to get rid of me?
I am trying to make your transition as smooth as possible, Dad. Get everything moving so you can just give me the...
Everything in its time, son. For now, I don't want to hear you speak a word of my retirement again.
Oh, I don't understand. You won't hear another word about your retirement come out of these lips.
Delegating. One of the many requirements of your job, right?
Are you sure you want Lucifer to take my place?
Believe me, Dad, I have my reservations, but Lucifer's come a long way. And he does his best when you put a little faith in him.
So how many of these games do you want me to win before we visit Lucifer's retirement home?
I'm glad you're back, Dad. I'm really enjoying spending this kind of time with you.
Me too, son.
But something's been bothering me. I mean, you're playing the perfect game.
Should I take it easy on you?
No, that's not it. That's not it. It's just, I don't know. It doesn't seem to me like you're losing it.
It's strange, isn't it? I feel fine.
When was the first time that you noticed a problem?
I didn't. Michael did. A few months back.
Michael noticed. And did you feel like you were losing control of your powers then?
Not in a way, but the more we talked about it, the more I realized I was.
You know we angels self-actualize, right? Dad, what if you self-actualize too? What if you're doing this to yourself?
Amenadiel says Dad didn't want to see any of the rest times I picked.
Huh. Do you think maybe he's reconsidering retiring, maybe?
You don't want me to be God, do you?
Lucifer, this whole case, you know, your mind has been elsewhere, and I just wonder if when you're actually ruling the universe, you don't have time for us. Just like your dad said that you didn't have time for your mom.
Detective, I have told you I've got to do things differently.
Said every child of every parent ever. Guys, so I checked Bruna's secret wire account, and it confirms Jeremy's story. She was totally receiving deposits from him.
So she was selling her fish?
That's not all. A few days before she was murdered, she received a Mondo transfer for $47,000.
The exact same amount that Bruna told Jeremy she needed.
Now, I don't know if it's a payment, but I was able to track the routing info to an IP registered to this address.
Oh, that sushi they're eating could be Bruna's fish. Recognize anyone?
Oh, Yakuza tattoos.
Wonderful. Who do you think's in charge?
I guess the impressive chap in red. I'll get us an audience.
But we have all the women.
Well, respect will get us further. The quickest way to earn that is to display superior skills in battle.
Battle? Lucifer, no.
Relax, detective. I'm vulnerable. Remember? Besides, my dad has been driving me up the wall with blasts of steam.
Lucifer.
Fancy another go? Very well, I'll go first. Solite Duca. Well, this doesn't seem like a very fair fight. Let's even things up, shall we?
Not Bruna's endangered fish. I only bought her good legal stuff.
$47,000 worth?
No, that was purely a donation I made because she was an honorable woman.
So honorable about making a profit selling endangered animals?
She wasn't keeping the money for herself. She was putting the money back into the aquarium to save the fish. The place was in dire straits. Without the $47K, the aquarium would go under.
So she was sacrificing a few fish to save the many.
Anyone else know what Bruna was doing?
A woman called from the aquarium asking about the donation, implying it was for some missing fish. She sounded angry. I didn't catch her name.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. See? Easy.
Yes, but which female employee would have motive to kill Bruna?
Well, who would be angry about the aquarium being used as a seafood bar than our old friend Lizzie? The woman who actually owns it?
Exactly. But we have no evidence to prove it.
So, what was it you wanted to see me about? Would anyone keep it?
Eve doesn't want it, so it's useless to me.
Maze. I am sorry that I didn't tell you about your mother. Wanted to. I don't know, maybe I shouldn't have kept my promise.
That's okay. Lucifer, I get it. You were just trying to protect me from having to face how
I meant her. So I hear you're going to be God.
If all goes well, you want to talk me out of it?
No. I want you to be God. So you can change one of the rules of hell for me.
Ah, yes. The Menethil told me you want me to change your hell loop.
No. I want you to change who can sit on the throne.
Father said hell no longer needed a woman.
But maybe it deserves one.
Is that what you really want?
I can't stay here, Lucifer. And I want to control who does the torturing.
Well, I can't think of anyone I would trust more with our old home. To Mezakin. Queen of Hell.
I was thinking of as a queen.
Daddy, what's her?
If you're looking for your son, he...
Enemy. Everyone has darkness in them. It's not about getting rid of it. It's about accepting it.
Yeah, but mine's different. Deeper. It attracts me to bad people. I think maybe I'm a bad person.
Child, the darker the darkness, the brighter the light. You, Miss Lopez, shine so very, very brightly. I can see it all the way from heaven.
Oh, those are the results.
Surprisingly great big picture kind of stuff. I mean, he did just pull off a pretty elaborate prank that made me think I got a bunch of people killed, so...
I'm sorry, Lucifer did what?
That doesn't matter. The point is, it was a pretty transformative experience for me, in a good way. So, Lucifer is God. I can think of crazier things.
Wow. Did not think I would ever hear that from you. But, that's not what I'm concerned about.
What are you worried about?
That he won't be able to balance being the ruler of the universe with being my boyfriend. Which, when I say out loud, sounds selfish. But...
I get it. It's a lot. But if it's any comfort, Lucifer's crazy about you. And you know that. You're crazy about him. So I think you should just try that, whatever challenges life throws at you.
Prepare to be impressed. So you guys remember how we couldn't find the victim's missing arm, right? So based on her husband saying that she had a Fitbit, I was able to track its serial number, ping its location, and boom, found it.
fingerprints on that arm might still be there.
Yeah, but the hand that we already have didn't produce any identifiable DNA, so with water and stomach acid, the chances are even slimmer with this arm.
Right. But the killer doesn't know that.
I don't know about this.
It's just a fish. If I could move it on my own, I would.
You're asking us to move a shark. I'm sorry, lady, but we gotta go.
You, moving something? Detective! This shark's grown to Luxford's tank. I'm transporting him to the marina in 7th grade.
Just 2 hours after I told you it's digesting a piece of evidence.
I couldn't imagine a more suspicious time to suddenly free Willie.
The shark's name is Andrew. And I'm sorry, but unless you have a warrant, then whatever's in Andrew's stomach is gonna have to stay there while I release him.
That's funny, because I thought you were a hands-off kind of boss.
Not when it comes to covering up our crimes, it seems.
Oh, and we do have a warrant. Our search team is in your office right now. Plus, I'm sure we'll find your DNA on Bruna's arm.
So I would say you are dead in the water, Izzy.
I was too hands-off. I found it too late that Bruna was playing dumb, choosing which fish would live and which ones would die. None of these beautiful creatures deserve that.
Sounds to me like Bruna wasn't the only one playing God. Did you enjoy sexing her?
I confronted her about what she was doing, and she spurred in my face. She said that she'd been telling me about our financial issues for years. That things got... I lost control. I didn't even know that I had the letter opener in my hand until I stabbed her with it. And why just listened to her and given her what she needed when she told me that none of this would ever happen.
Well, Elizabeth, name in your arrest for the murder of Bruna Lorenzoni.
Just made me realize something. Nothing I've been listening at all to what my father truly wants in his retirement. Just excuse me. Something I need to do.
You said at dinner. I mean, do you really think I'd make your father give up his dreams?
Well, I don't know if you made him, but he did.
Oh, darling. You always think you know everything. Your father and I had a deal. We would take turns. He'd hold off on becoming a detective until I got my acting career going. And then after a few years, we would switch. But when it came time for his turn,
he died.
officer.
Lucifer. Why'd you call us here, brother?
Well, after finally listening to what Dad's been telling me all along, I realized that only one thing's going to make it retirement fulfilling. So, I enlisted Gabriel's help to make it happen. Did you know my sister could deliver a message anyway? And I mean, anyway.
It's a tough gig. I should understand that now that you're doing it.
I don't find it nearly as difficult as you made it out to be.
Clearly you're better at it than I ever was. No surprise in that.
Well, I must admit, though,
everything can go back to normal. Everything. We can be a family again. Wonderful. Except for the part where I don't get to become God and prove that I'm worthy. Just until this. So, looks like my plans for Dad's retirement have got to a smashing start. What's it gonna be? Good old Florida? Back up to the Silver City?
We have decided. We're moving to my universe.
What? But you're both here, together. You're just gonna leave us again? Without any ability to come back?
Your mother spent her long. Losing it. There's no need for you to retire. You can just keep on being God.
I thought you wanted to be God.
I did. Like, I do.
You've only just got me here.
Can't you stay and annoy me for a bit longer?
Choice in the matter.
I've given you a life of choice. This one's mine.
mysterious ways. Just as you leave, eh?
No need for them anymore, now that I'm retired. Which means I can say something I've wanted to for a long time. I have loved you, son.
Mysterious ways already.
All part of the plan.
Plan? How much of this was your bag?
I decided something. I'm quitting the LAPD.
Sorry, I thought I heard you say you were quitting the LAPD.
Yeah. I became a cop so that I could do good and help people. And ask God, you'll have the power to help, well, everyone. So if I can help you become God, then I'll help everyone as well.
Are you sure? I mean, how can I call you the detective if you're not actually a detective?
Christopher, you've been helping me do my job for the last 5 years. Now it's my turn to support you. That's what partners do, right? I'll take that as a yes.
Lucifer! Where's Father?
Excuse us. We were having a moment.
Where is he?
Gone. Eternally unavailable.
Did he name his successor?
No. He said it was up to us to figure it out. Why?
Can we talk? Without the human?
No. What you want to say to me, you can say it in front of my consultant.
So be it. Upon returning to the Silver City, I discovered something alarming. Michael's been gathering support from the others.
Support for what?
Michael wants to be God. Snake. was his plan all along.
If it's up to our brothers and sisters, it looks like he has a good shot, which is why I cannot believe I am saying this. I am backing you, Lucifer. I may not like you, but I hate Michael even more.
And there's a ringing endorsement for my campaign poster.
Michael would never suspect I'd take your side. So, I'll find out what he's up to.
Whatever it is, it can't be good.
And knowing my brother, he won't be wasting his time. Azrael really should have kept a better eye on her blade. Telling me that Michael has got your votes because he's a devil, you know. Do you have any idea how ironically infuriating that is?
Sorry, Luce, I just don't see you as God material. What's up, Bill? Hey, cool if I hang for a while? Everything's calm, right? Love you, bro.
Oh.
Yeah, I've just been thinking about this next chapter and my our lives and what it entails. I mean, do I have to pick my own rules?
You can do whatever you want.
Well, do I need to pull Lucy out of school? It's this semester, not the best timing. I mean, can I come? Or does it not work that way? Oh, God, does this mean I have to die?
No, of course not. And there's plenty of time to figure out logistics when and if I become good.
Right, yeah, you're right. I'm just trying to wrap my mind around what all of this means and the weight of it.
Detective, you haven't handed in your 2-week notice yet, have you?
No, not yet. I will. I mean, you don't think I'm getting cold feet, do you? My feet are warm as ever.
Right, well, maybe just chill them a smidge, because I'm not sure I can convince my siblings I'm the right angel for the god job.
Lucifer, if anyone in the entire universe can persuade them, it's you.
No, you're right. You're right, what was I thinking? Shall we, future Mrs. G? Wow. Glad to see you.
I know. I was kind of looking forward to cracking open a nice bottle of Zin later. Now, not so much.
I did it. Speaking of wine, you know who'd be a great partner to enjoy some wine?
Well,
my old partner.
Wow. Really smooth transition there, Dan.
Come on, just hear me out, okay? Please?
Fine.
Great. So my good buddy, Carol Corbett.
He's got a girl's name? I'm out.
Yeah, but he's a guy. He's a good one. We were partnered up in the academy. But then he had to move back east.
Immature playgrounds, strike two.
He went back to help his mother when she got sick. But now he's in town, doesn't really know anybody. And I don't know, I got this hunch. You guys would hit it off.
Dan. I appreciate the offer. I really, really do. But I just... The truth is, I'm finally at peace with everything that happened. And with myself, getting back to neutral, and I really don't want to throw a dude into the mix.
I get it. I just think that you deserve someone equally as great as you are.
What a tragedy.
Oh, I know. It's always sad when someone... You're talking about the wine, aren't you?
Heartbreaking, yes.
Who's the victim? Our enophile is Jonathan Donnelly, 53, a tech in the medical examiner's office. Cause of death, 2 gunshots to the chest, .45 caliber.
What about the bruises?
Well, it looks like he was tied down and forced to drink wine for a couple of hours before he was shot.
So you're saying he was waterboarded?
Do we know why he was here?
Yeah, this is his wine locker.
Don't be ridiculous, Daniel. A man of the departed stature and income could never afford such an exquisite wine collection.
Great point.
Yes.
I'll look into his financials.
Anything else? So we also found a partial shoe print from a wine puddle over there. I mean, I doubt there's enough to match with anything, but we did get the victim's phone, and a few days ago, he got a really mean text from someone named Mo. You screwed me. You're gonna pay. I'll check the LUDs and see who the number one switch.
Thanks, Ella.
Wanted you all to hear it from me first, that I just put in my 2 weeks notice because I'm retiring. Many of my very best memories have happened right here. The good, the bad, the crazy. I know that the work we all do can be incredibly challenging, but I wouldn't want to do it with anyone else.
each and every one of you, so it's not goodbye. It's just goodbye for now, all right?
Did you know about this?
No. But I got a pretty good idea what it's all about. Or should I say who it's about? For you, Chloe.
Thank you. I, on the other hand, am very mucho not excited for you. I don't want to solve crimes without you. Come on, Decker. Retire? Is this really how it's gonna end? What, you're gonna take up scrapbooking? You're gonna foster cats? Hmm?
I'm actually helping Lucifer take over the family business.
So you're both leaving?
Chase?
This was my choice.
Sorry. It's just Florida. You guys, that is so far.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's where Lucifer's family business is, right?
We'll be a tad north of Florida, but you know, I'm still gonna be here for you. I'm always gonna be around, you know, from a distance. At least I think that's how it works, and no need to worry. For now, let's focus on the case. Did we find out who sent threatening texts?
Mm-hmm. Odetta Watson. Apparently, she's a psychic with an office on Highland.
Maybe she can divine us some clues.
Yeah. Find out if I'm acquitted of your murder after you abandon me.
Excuse me?
Nothing.
I can feel your great uncertainty in this time of change. You are worried about a health issue. That could potentially develop due to all the stress you are having over a opportunity?
Yes, I'm up for a big promotion in the family business.
Right. Oh, I can see it clearly now. But there is strife within the family.
Right, because all families are functional.
And it seems you are not the only one vying for the job.
Amazing, yes. My no-good manipulative bastard of a brother is trying to steal it out from under me. In fact, there are just a few swing votes left. Can you tell me how to convince my siblings I'm the right man for the job?
You must lean into your strengths.
Lean into my strengths of genius.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I am sensing you are the skeptic in the relationship.
How is she even doing this?
So, why are you here? We are here about Jonathan Donnelly.
Who is that?
He's the guy that you've been sending threatening texts to, and don't bother denying it. Your phone records show repeated calls and texts to and from him.
Oh, that Jonathan, yes. Yes, I didn't know you meant him. I have read for him in the past.
Hold on, if you're a real psychic, surely you would have known that.
Actually, my specialty is channeling the dead, and since Jonathan is very much alive...
Jonathan is very much dead. Tortured and shot in his wine locker shortly after receiving your threatening text.
Hang on, Jonathan is dead? And you think I did it?
How did you not see that coming?
She's not a psychic. She's a con artist. You advertise that you can locate lost items from dead relatives, and you know who would be the perfect accomplice in that scam? A tech from the ME's office who has access to bodies and their valuables.
That is absurd. I would never.
One call to a judge, I subpoena your records, I get proof, and you go down for fraud and murder.
Hang on now. I didn't kill anybody, okay? Why would I kill Jonathan? Our hustle was genius. He would steal a valuable off a body, plant it somewhere, and then use targeted online ads to direct the family to use me.
And then you magically find the family heirloom?
Yep.
Well, you may not be a real medium, but that is an excellent scam. Respect.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
But you see why I would be a total idiot to stop that money train, right?
Where were you last night at 8 p.m.?
Giving a reading to a programming exec at Fox.
Oh, good luck with that.
So, just say that story checks out. Do you know of anyone else who would want to hurt Jonathan?
Maybe one of the other families found out that their stuff was being sold?
What do you mean, other families?
The ones that didn't bite. Jonathan would give whatever he took from their dead relative to a fence named TJ, and then TJ would sell it on the black market.
Great. What's TJ's last name?
I don't know. But I know that he works out of Hollywood.
Helpful.
Boom. Rainbow lasso. Which means I get to take Mr. Narwhal and put him in my stable.
Yeah, no. Dad, you can only throw a rainbow lasso if she's in your hand at the beginning of your turn.
Well, come on. You know what? These rules are confusing.
Or maybe I'm just better at building unicorn armies.
Yeah, right.
I would.
What? On. Again?
Want another shot at the unicorn title?
Yeah.
But I go first because I'm wearing the most colorful clothes. Okay, fine. I'll lend you my glitter scarf and then you can go first. But you have to wear it.
I promise.
Yeah, and I have to go find it.
Cool. I'll clean up our mess.
Hey, what's up, man?
Dan, I figured it out.
What's that?
What I'm gonna do here, now that I've decided to stay.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna become a policeman. I mean, I really like helping people, and what better way to do that than putting away criminals?
You wouldn't be a cop.
Wouldn't it be great? I mean, we could even work together one day.
Oh, yeah. An angel and a detective solving crimes makes total sense.
But you don't think it's a good idea?
No, it's just...
Bro, you're a freaking angel.
You're almost God. I mean, there's gotta be something that better suits your skill set.
So you think it's a bad idea because I wouldn't be any good at it?
No, that's not what I said. It's just that there are different kinds of people, different kinds of jobs.
You know something? Of all people, I really thought you'd be the one that would be most excited for me.
I'm in the deal. Okay. That's not what I meant. Not what I meant.
Why bother, Lucifer? You're not getting my vote. Yeah, I supported you once in the rebellion, but then I had to suffer Dad's passive-aggressive wrath. Try cleaning out that proverbial doghouse. And it certainly doesn't help your case that even Joe Field, who, let's face it, is an idiot. Even he thinks your pitch is lacking. Truth is, I'm only here as a courtesy.
Sarah, what is it you truly desire?
You seriously think I'm going to fall for your silly little parlor trick?
I'm not so wise woman recently suggested I lean into my strengths.
Well, too bad she didn't teach you how to cut your losses.
I learned I needed to ask not what the angels can do for you, but what can you do for the angels?
I have no idea what that means.
It means you're right. I shouldn't try and convince you I'd be a better god than Michael. What I should do is the one thing I can do better than anyone, and that is grant favors. So, again, I humbly ask you. What is it you desire?
I'm an angel, Lucifer. I'm totally above the base passions and petty desires that humans fall prey to.
Oh my god. Is that Michael Voltaggio?
You mean Top Chef champion Michael Voltaggio? Why, yes it is.
Hey, you're Lucifer's sister, right?
Oh my god. Michael, is that really you in the flesh? I mean, you, I can't. You're a pure divine, and I should know because I am an angel, but you are such a bad boy, and I'm feeling hungry.
Oh. Anyway, Michael, would you excuse us for just a moment?
Sure, I'll just be over at the bar.
Okay.
So, I have arranged for you to have the full Vault VIP experience, a Friday night reservation for life at Estuary, his new restaurant in DC, Michael's special recipe for rice pina, and his personal phone number. In exchange, all I ask is for your support.
I gotta hand it to you, Lucifer. It's gonna be really hard to say no after that.
Excellent.
Amazing. Thank you.
Well, truth be told, Michael owes me. How else do you think you won Top Chef? That squab was inedible.
Still, I mean, this is a really big deal. You must really want to be God. Actually, why do you want it so badly?
Right.
You know what? I actually need to think about this a little more.
Sorry,
I should go.
Michael Voltaggio is the worst.
What are you talking about?
A campaign to become God has hit another snag. It's a disaster.
It can't be that bad.
Well, at least it's not boring, unlike this. A final case. I mean, how many fences called TJ can there be in Hollywood? We've seen six already.
Well, we only have five to go. And come on, you're not going to miss this? Even a little bit?
I'd rather have a colonoscopy.
Well, for me, it's the shoe leather. The day-to-day chasing down the boring long shots, you know? That's the fun part. I am going to miss it.
You know what I am going to miss? That look in your eyes right now. Maybe you shouldn't quit.
What? No, I want to. I want to be with you.
Stolen goodies.
Oh, looks like we found the right TJ.
Oh, vintage Rolex. What sort of idiot thief would leave this behind? It's worth a fortune.
I bet this boot mark is going to match the one we found at the wine cellar. Well, whoever searched this place was definitely looking for something in particular.
I wonder if they found it.
Found what?
TJ Ross?
Who wants to know?
Detective Decker, LAPD, we're here to talk to you about the death of Jonathan Donnelly.
Stay away. I don't want to hurt you.
You? That's us. Adorable. Come along now, TJ.
TJ Ross's house. Bigger than any of his shoes, but it does match the shoe print we found at the wine locker.
So whoever killed Jonathan Donnelly also ransacked TJ's place?
They had to be looking for something Jonathan stole off a corpse.
Given what was left behind, I say they haven't found it yet.
But what is this object? Who wants it? And why? And where does our killer buy his enormous boots? It's all a mystery, isn't it? A thrilling, tangled web of discovery and contradiction that you two are never going to see because you're running off to stupid Alabama.
She thinks we're going north of Florida. We're definitely not going there.
Alabama's actually really nice.
Well, you wouldn't think that.
Okay, everybody, let's focus on the killer. Our priority now is TJ us, and that might lead us to him. Lucifer and I will focus on his friends and family.
And there are TJ's usual clients.
Yeah, but the client list we found on TJ's computer runs in the hundreds.
I foresee great boredom in my future.
You know what? Why don't I get started on the list?
Are you sure?
Yeah. I missed your last case. Least I could do is help with the groundwork.
Thank you, Dad. He'll take one for the team.
Hey, you.
Yeah.
You forgot this.
What's that?
It's my friend Carol's phone number.
Dan, no!
Please, you gotta call him, please. Please, for me. Yes! You won't regret it, I promise.
Mm-hmm. You better be cute!
Beautiful!
We still have to figure out what was going on with that certain kick. Are we dealing with someone celestial?
I don't know. I have a theory. I can check it out.
Okay. You go find out where DJ is, and I'll track down where he is. Says, you know, I've returned to fiercely rule over you for all of eternity. But like, not in a needy way. Think murderously aspirational.
Well, I like the blue one.
Yeah, you're not helping, Linda.
Okay. Is it possible that you're fixating on this outfit because you're really worried about something else?
Well, I am worried that Lucifer won't pull his head out of his ass and become God.
Yeah, no, I was actually thinking that you might be concerned about becoming Queen of Hell.
What would worry me about that?
Well, maybe that you have a soul now, and you might be worried that that soul might hinder the joy you once felt by torturing others.
Yeah. The whole soul thing, it isn't for me. I'm the one who grew it, so I'm just gonna let it slowly suffocate and die. Like I did with Chad.
Who's Chad?
Doesn't matter.
Okay, so, Maze, listen. You grew a soul through the relationships that you nurtured here on Earth. Through the moments that you shared with people who care about you. Like me. Are you really sure that you want to just suffocate the wonderful times we've shared? I'm overtly trying to get in your head. You don't have to do this.
Yes, I do. The alternative is much worse.
Ah, there you are. What are you wearing? You're like a bony xylophone. Doctor, would you excuse us just a moment?
I thought you'd never ask.
Have you heard of any demons roaming the earth lately?
Why?
To be a human with super strength and a hurdling technique to match running around Hollywood.
I haven't heard of any. But you never know. The throne of hell is empty after all. If you are concerned, there is an easy way for you to get the underworld in check.
Yes, yes, get elected God so I can make you queen. I get it. Just keep an eye out for rogue demons and don't worry about the election.
Do you? Zacul is your last swing vote, and he hates you.
Yes, he does. But I have a plan. I'm going to tell him something I've never told anyone before.
What's that?
I was wrong. I know. It's a miracle. But as much as it pains me to say, my rebellion was ill-conceived. Why? Because I did it for the wrong reasons. I rebelled out of anger at father, out of a desire to prove that I was better than him. I've changed. I've spent my time on growing, getting over my daddy issues. I know how monumental his job actually was and is now. Those are big shoes to fill, but I promise you, Samuel, I will give it my absolute best. Lucifer.
Wow.
Well spoken. Emotionally evolved. Wow.
enough to possibly win over the Angel of Rights.
I mean, no. It's always going to be a no.
You don't want to meet Michael Bartagio, do you?
I'm just here for the whiskey. JoJo said you bribed the top shelf. And to watch you grovel.
God, it was never going to work, was it? All that nonsense about making peace with father and growing as an angel. You know, the crazy thing is it's all true, but it's not the whole truth. You really want to know why I'm doing all this? Why I'm trying to become God? I'm doing it for love. And it gets worse. I'm doing it for the love of a human. I am trying to be God so that I can finally be worthy of her. So there you have it. Enjoy the top shelf.
This woman, is she a good father maybe for you?
Her name is Chloe Decker, and she is much more than that. So yes, I am doing this for the wrong reasons again, but you know what? I don't care. All I care about is her, which is why I have to make this happen, and I will, no matter what the cost, with or without your vote.
Brooke Fryer?
Not Miss Fryer.
Detective Espinosa with the LAPD. Listen, we know that you were a client of TJ Ross. I'll make it a trivia book. Sorry. We have information regarding a possible threat. Somebody's after one of TJ's stolen items, and they've already killed somebody to try and get it.
That's horrible.
Yeah, yes, ma'am, it is. And if I can find you, the killer can find you. So I'm just wondering if you've noticed anything out of the ordinary. You know, any strangers lurking around, anything like that?
No. I haven't. And if that's all I should go, I've got a roast in the oven.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for your time. You have a beautiful day.
Thank you. Was ransacked too, so maybe the killer didn't find what they were looking for.
We have the sense to keep that alive.
Right. So let's just do our job and let's find it.
Okay. The last class. So there was a scuffle.
Let's walk back.
Guys. He doesn't even have his phone.
This is bad.
No, this is Daniel. He's more than capable.
You're right. Hey. I think there's something there, too.
Yeah. It definitely seems like there was some kind of fight.
Hey, Red. Looks like there's something down there.
Been using the same one since the 40s.
Got a name?
Yep.
Algerian, dishonorably discharged. He's been linked to a ruthless mercenary group led by this guy, Vincent Lamac.
Right, we got running guns, kidnapping, murder. So he's impossible to find because they never leave witnesses. This is all my fault. I've been so focused on finding TJ that I forgot the detective work and now Tim's.
No, you said it yourself. We can't go there.
Exactly. We are going to find him myself. We're going to find him.
Who took down?
I'll kill him.
Hmm? This guy? Who is he?
Vincent Lamac. He's a French mercenary, and we have no idea where he is.
I'll find him.
I have no doubt, Lesser King, but time is of the utmost essence. We need all the help we can get, and you know who's good at finding criminals.
Other criminals.
Lucky for us, there are a lot who owe me favors.
Which papers do you want me to call in?
All of them.
Why are you showing me a grave? This is supposed to be some sort of threat.
You're lying.
Superhuman strength running around L.A.
Nice, and I don't think he's a demon.
Could this be Michael-related?
No, I talked to Romeo. Michael's still in the Silver City.
Yes, but couldn't TJ be doing his bidding?
But why would Michael use a lonely jewelry fence? And it still doesn't explain TJ's super strength. Or how this could even help Michael win an election.
Got a list of places the mercenaries could be. Great. How many? A lot. Okay. We divide and conquer. The angels take the furthest location, and this time, nobody goes along.
You see?
No.
Tell Tracy that I love her.
Tell her that I'm going to miss making unicorn armies for her.
Yeah, no. Can you tell her yourself, okay? Hear me. You stay with her. Stay with me. Look at me. Breathe. Breathe.
Somebody named Caleb. I don't know. None of that makes sense.
Wait. Caleb? I think I know what this is about. Caleb Mayfield was the boy who was killed. I tried to help him.
Yes, I helped you in the aftermath, but what does Caleb have to do with Michael?
Before Caleb was buried, I laid my necklace on his body.
Yes, what?
Somebody obviously came looking for it.
But it wasn't there. The tech in the coroner's office must have stolen it from the body. And Michael
hired the mercenaries to find it, and then they tortured and killed him, but he didn't have it either, because TJ the Fence has it. Which explains his super strength.
It does. How?
Well, think about it. Every piece of the flaming sword has a power. Asriel's blade is death, the hilt, divine love, and your necklace is the strength that binds them together, strength that apparently lends itself to whoever's in possession of it.
My necklace has been in human hands before. It's never granted any of them super strength.
Well, the hilt was only activated when Asriel's blade was on Earth. I suppose the same could be true of your necklace.
Wait, but I thought you threw Asriel's blade into Mom's universe.
I did. But I also just sent Gabriel there to send her a message, and something tells me she did not return empty-handed.
So Gabriel's working with Michael.
Smallest of our problems, brother. Biggest being, Michael is trying to assemble the flaming sword. He's not trying to win an election.
He's trying to win a war.
Michael's plan. This is his fault, not yours.
I keep playing it over and over. Fine, I just... This is my case, and I let him go alone. He's... Please tell me that this is all for something bigger. Please. That you're gonna win, and that you can fix this, that you're gonna be God.
Track record when it comes to raging wars in heaven. And insult to injury, I didn't manage to convince a single swing boat. Zekiel said no, surprise, surprise. Honestly, the engineer of my demise.
What does that mean?
Well, in a fit of candor, I told him the real truth as to why I was doing all this, and it went over like a lead balloon.
What's the truth? Why are you doing this?
Then I'll finally be worthy of you.
See, you're telling me that Trixie is in there right now crying herself to sleep. And the real reason that she's gonna grow up without her father is because you still don't know what I feel about you. Is that even possible? If that's the case, Lucifer.
Lopez. Hi, I'm Pure Corbett. As in
the guy that Dan was trying to set me up with, right?
Yeah.
Sorry to even... Dan was always just looking out for me, you know?
Yeah. Me too. I think he was always looking out for everyone.
Yeah, he was.
Speaking of which, there's a friend I need to talk to.
Of course, yeah. Last time I saw him, I said some things that I can never take back.
I know. You told me.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was considering becoming a cop, and I don't think Dan thought it was a good idea.
That's where you're wrong, Amelia. That's what I came over here to tell you. The day he died, he turned in your application to the police academy. At least we both know he's in a better place now, right?
Something I have to tell you. I went to see Dan in heaven.
Let me guess. Swimming in a bath of chocolate.
He's not there, Lucy.
What?
He's not there. Dan isn't in heaven. I went to check.
As much.
So you and I both know that guilt is much more complicated and deep-seated than we're even aware of.
That's not fair.
None of this is. First arrived in Los Angeles, I was angry. I was angry and confused about the place in the world. I didn't know how to connect with people. But Dan did. And he taught me how to be a good friend, how to be a good father. He taught me how to be a good man, because he was a good man. The sad thing is, I think he forgot that sometimes, but he was a good, good man. Always trying to do right by others. Always trying to do better. Even though he was already the very best of us. What happened to Dan? It isn't fair. And you have every right to feel angry about it. But you can't take comfort in knowing that Dan is in a much better place. I'm really gonna miss you with all will.
this day forward, I will always try and do better.
Sure.